Hi, this is Kia once again. Welcome to Prayer Line. Precious one, I want you to know that today is the day the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Precious one, beloved, I want you to know that I'm about to show you a video about some of the reasons why people are so convinced, without a shadow of doubt, that the world is not coming to an end. And for that reason, Jesus Christ is not coming soon, or Jesus Christ is not even coming, and all this thing about rapture, great tribulation, mark of the beast, 666, new world order, it's just jokes and gimmicks. There is this video I just watched, and I knew that is how a lot of guys are thinking. Because of these things, they believe that the coming of Jesus Christ is nothing, it's just speculation, and it is just fear-mongering news being spread by these Christians, and they are citing example from her campaign's predictions and all these things.
2012, the end of the Mayan calendar, and we're entering the final countdown before the world is supposed to end in catastrophic earthquakes on December 21st. But if recent history is any guide, you probably shouldn't blow your life savings making the most of your last months on Earth. It's been a busy few years for failed doomsday predictions. Just last year, California pastor Harold Camping made international headlines, predicting the world would end on May 21st, 2011. He inspired many of his followers to sell their possessions to help spread the word. But when the rapture didn't come on schedule, he blamed a math error and said it would come October 21st. Oops. In 2010, the opening of the Large Hadron Collider, a huge high-energy particle accelerator deep underground in Switzerland, led to fears it would create a black hole that would swallow up the Earth, but it started up without incident. Failed predictions of the end of the world are nothing new. Some medieval Christians thought the year 1000 would herald the coming of the Antichrist and the end of the world. In the 1840s, a preacher named William Miller attracted tens of thousands of followers behind his doomsday prediction. Like Camping, he set a specific date for the rapture based on his reading of the Bible, April 23rd, 1843. When the day came and went, he said the end would absolutely, positively happen on October 22nd, 1844. When October 23rd came and went, followers called it the Great Disappointment. And while that's one of the most notorious failed apocalypses yet, check back on December 22nd.
But precious one, the truth of the matter is that it is great deception. It is the deception of the devil to use all these failed fixed dates, which many people have fixed dates over the years. The devil allowed all these things to happen in order to bring people to the point whereby they are now so convinced that, hey, this thing about doomsday or judgment day or rapture is nothing but fake and just rumors and it's just ordinary talk. And that is how the devil has been able to, over the years, been able to bring about all these fixed dates, because the Bible clearly shows or tells us that nobody knows the day nor the time Jesus Christ is coming. Nobody really knows that. So anyone who fixes dates are going to certainly get it wrong. But that doesn't mean that we don't know the day or nor the hour. God has also given us the wisdom to be able to understand the times and seasons, just like the children of Issachar, and who were part of the tribe of Israel. The Bible makes us to understand that they understood the times. Bible says that when we see wars and rumors of wars and earthquakes, pestilence and deception, these are all wake-up calls that the coming of Christ is very, very close. And today, look into your world, look into the news. It's like we are living in a prophetic timeline. Everything that Jesus Christ gave as signals that he's coming is now showing up. So please don't be deceived by the old false predictions that did not come to pass. Don't let it make you feel as though there's nothing to it, because that is where the devil wanted to bring people to lie. It's like the child crying wolf, 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 and every time they go, they realize that there's no wolf. Then the day the wolf really shows up to attack the child, she cries out wolf, wolf, because people know that she's been playing games and gimmicks over the years. They don't take it seriously, but when they went, she was devoured, destroyed by the wolf, because the wolf actually showed up.
All I'm here to tell you, I'm not here to fix dates because I don't really know when Jesus is coming back, and I don't know when this world is coming to an end. But all I can tell you for fact, for truth, is that we are living in prophetic timeline, and any time from now, very soon, Jesus is coming back. All the signs, the European nations falling apart, all the signs with the earthquakes and tsunamis and terrorism and pestilence and hurricanes and famine, everything is showing that the world is certainly coming to an end. We are living in the prophetic timeline. All I'm here to tell you is that please make sure that you are spiritually ready. How do you get spiritually ready? By knowing Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior, accepting Him, because He's the way, the truth, and the life. He's the door to heaven. He's the gate to heaven. Without Jesus Christ, you have no eternal life. And also making sure that if you are a Christian, then you are still pressing on, you are still redeeming the times, you are still preparing yourself in season and out of season. Every single day of your life, you are living it as though Jesus Christ is coming the next minute, the next second, because he can show up any moment from now, because He has given us every prophetic thing that He said is showing up. When people talk about Great Tribulation will be the 6 years after the rapture. For right now, people are going through their own tribulation already. Last time we had our 5.7 magnitude of earthquake in Maryland and eastern borders. So we've had our tribulation. If you go to the Horn of Africa, people are experiencing famine and dying out of starvation. They are going through their tribulation. People are having tsunami and hurricanes. If you go to Japan, tsunami. Australia, flooding. If you go to European nations, the euro is falling apart and nations are collapsing. People are losing houses, losing their homes, losing their jobs, losing their properties. It is all tribulations for them. But very soon, the great tribulation itself will be coming. The question is that how ready are you? I'm here to tell you that please don't be deceived. Jesus is indeed coming very soon. And if you refuse to accept Him now, and the rapture happens and you are left behind, then I admonish you, I warn you, don't take the 666 mark, the mark of the beast, which you can't buy, sell without it. But if you avoid it, you have life and you will save your soul. But if you take the mark of the beast, you'll be doomed to hell. So please don't take the mark of the beast. For those of you who will be rebellious and who will be stubborn and who will think that you are too wise and not accept Jesus Christ, please, during the time of great tribulation, don't take the mark of the mark of the beast, the identification mark of the Antichrist. You can't buy, you can't sell. Imagine you can't buy water, food, clothing, rent a house. You can't do anything we need money for, you can't, unless you have that mark. And when you get or you receive that mark, you are doomed for hell. So please, during that time, you'll be persecuted if you also don't take that mark. It will be like a credit card or an identification mark on your forehead or on the palm of your hand. But please, that will be your last chance. Don't take that mark of the beast. But why do you want to go through the tribulation? Why do you want to go through those times? This is the opportunity for you to accept Jesus now, so that when the trumpet sounds and Jesus Christ shows up with His holy angels, the Bible says that the dead in Christ will rise up, and those living who believe in Him will be also caught up. Why don't you become part of those who will be raptured, who are getting themselves ready for the soon return of our Lord Jesus Christ? Apart from the Bible, people from different Maya calendar and other religious groups are also predicting that the world is coming to an end very soon. Some are even predicting that it is the year 2012. Personally, I don't know when Jesus Christ is coming, but all the near-death experiences and the signs going on shows that very, very, very soon. I don't know how very is, but very, very, very soon He'll be showing up. Get yourself ready. And I know this message, you are not going to hear it in your churches, because most of the pastors are not preparing the body of Christ for the soon return of Jesus Christ. They are just enjoying themselves and having entertainment in the desecrated pagan adulterous churches. Now please step out and begin to prepare yourself. Make sure you know Jesus Christ for yourself and you have one-on-one personal relationship with Him. Make sure that you are filled with the precious blood of Jesus. You are filled with the Holy Spirit. Your sins are covered by the blood. You are always living a holy life. You are confessing your sins and you are living by manifesting the fruit of the Spirit. Love, joy, peace, patience, humility, self-control, kindness. You are allowing the Holy Spirit to live through you. And you are dead to the world and dead to yourself. And you are living your life in righteousness. The Bible says, blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they shall be filled. Life is short. Life is short. And also, I want you to know, life is short and heaven is real and hell is also real. Life is very fragile. If you don't believe me, when you meet Michael Jackson and Steve Jobs, ask them. They will tell you that life is very fragile. Life is very short. So please make the best choice and decision now. That will be the best choice you ever make. This world is certainly coming to an end. There are strange noises going all over the world. No famine, pestilence, terrorism. No. Right now, look at the conflict going between American and Iran. Very soon, who knows, war. No, and then food shortage will be kicking in. Gas prices will be going up. No, already this nation, people are unemployed. Almost we have 23 million Americans unemployed. Almost 49 million Americans living in poverty line. One out of every 6 persons you live is living in poverty line. The nation America, one of the greatest nations in the world right now, is having trillions in debt. No, everywhere you turn, chaos, confusion. No, so please, it's a wake-up call. It's a wake-up call. But if you don't accept Jesus, don't take the mark of the beast, the 666. Prepare yourself, for Jesus is coming soon. Make sure you stay in tune to watch the video. That video is some of the things the devil is using right now to convince people why they should think as though Jesus Christ is not coming soon or the world is not coming to an end. So please don't buy into these things. Prepare yourself every single day as though Jesus is coming. May God richly bless you. Bye.
It's 2012, the end of the Mayan calendar, and we're entering the final countdown before the world is supposed to end in catastrophic earthquakes on December 21st. But if recent history is any guide, you probably shouldn't blow your life savings making the most of your last months on Earth. It's been a busy few years for failed doomsday predictions. Just last year, California pastor Harold Camping made international headlines, predicting the world would end on May 21st, 2011. He inspired many of his followers to sell their possessions to help spread the word. But when the rapture didn't come on schedule, he blamed a math error and said it would come October 21st. Oops. In 2010, the opening of the Large Hadron Collider, a huge high-energy particle accelerator deep underground in Switzerland, led to fears it would create a black hole that would swallow up the Earth, but it started up without incident. Failed predictions of the end of the world are nothing new. Some medieval Christians thought the year 1000 would herald the coming of the Antichrist and the end of the world. In the 1840s, a preacher named William Miller attracted tens of thousands of followers behind his doomsday prediction. Like Camping, he set a specific date for the rapture based on his reading of the Bible, April 23rd, 1843. When the day came and went, he said the end would absolutely, positively happen on October 22nd, 1844. When October 23rd came and went, followers called it the Great Disappointment. And while that's one of the most notorious failed apocalypses yet, check back on December 22nd.